Hi! As you can see, we're on the Features tab of the general settings of Yoast SEO. By now, you already know that Yoast SEO comes with a lot of features. And on the Features tab, you can enable and disable some of them. Now, I'm not going to chew over all of these features separately, as we've already discussed most of them in previous videos. So, what I will do in this video is focus on the features you probably haven't heard of yet, or need to know more about. By the way, if you want to refresh your memory, you can always click the question mark to get some more information about a specific feature. See? Well, with that being said, let's skip the first features and talk about the text link counter. This feature counts your internal links. You can find the two counters in your post overview. Here they are. We've already described this feature in a previous video, but we didn't tell you how we call it. So now you know, it's called the text link counter. Okay, let's go back to the Features tab and move on to XML sitemaps, the roadmaps of your website that lead Google to all your important pages. As WordPress also comes with a built-in XML sitemap, I think you might have some questions about this feature. We've already told you that the XML sitemap feature in WordPress is very basic. And the one in Yoast SEO is sophisticated with a number of enhancements and performance improvements. That's why we advise you to enable this feature. If you do, we automatically turn off the default WordPress XML sitemap and make sure that ours runs flawlessly. If you disable the XML sitemap functionality in Yoast SEO by toggling the switch to off, we don't disable the WordPress core XML sitemaps. You'll still get these as a fallback. Okay, now onto this security feature. By default, it's enabled, which makes sure that only editors and administrators can change things in the advanced section and in the schema settings of your Yoast SEO meta box and sidebar. Let's go there to refresh your memory. So, in the schema settings, you can change schema metadata for a post or page. And in the advanced section, you can determine whether you want to show a post in the search results or set a canonical. We assume these are things you might not want any author to do, and that's why we have this security feature. If you toggle the switch to off, you will allow all authors to change these settings. Next is usage tracking. It allows us to track some data about your site to improve our plugin. For example, we track which plugin features you use and how you use them, while anonymizing them, of course. This gives us insights into which features people use and what the most common settings are. And this allows us to make better product decisions, because we know how you use our plugin. If you're using Yoast SEO Free, usage tracking is only on when you explicitly opt in. When you install Yoast SEO Premium, we opt you in by default. You can, however, opt out by setting this toggle to off. If you click this link, you can read which data we track and why. Okay, what about this REST API? With this feature, we hope to support those people building headless WordPress sites a lot better. Headless sites don't have a head, by which we mean front end. In other words, they only have a back end, which is used for content management. Developers using headless WordPress installs can now generate metadata from a front-end request. Thanks to a simple metadata endpoint, developers can use the REST API to grab the data and output it wherever they want. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, you can just ignore this feature. And finally, one of our latest features is enhanced Slack sharing. Slack is a very popular tool for professional communication. It's also a place where colleagues often share information they find around the web. Chances are people also share links from your site on Slack. But are you doing everything you can to make those links attractive to click on? This feature can make your website stand out on Slack by enhancing your link previews. It adds an author byline and an estimated reading time to your metadata. It could look like this. So, if you share a URL from your site on Slack, it will now look much better and gives you more information about who wrote it and how long it would take to read. which brings us to the end of this video. Bye!